गुड इवनिंग चिल्ड्रन, वंस अगेन वेलकम टू ऑनलाइन क्लास. सो आई हैव कंप्लीटेड सो फार नाउ टू बायोलॉजी लेसन्स, दैट इज क्रॉप प्रोडक्शन एंड मैनेजमेंट, माइक्रो ऑर्गेनिजम्स, फ्रेंड एंड फो, एंड केमिस्ट्री, सिंथेटिक फाइबर्स एंड प्लास्टिक्स, फिजिक्स, फोर्स एंड प्रेशर. सो टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू स्टार्ट विद वन मोर केमिस्ट्री लेसन, दैट इज मटीरियल्स चैप्टर 4, metals and non-metals. I hope all the children have taken the textbook. If not, so far you can go and take the textbooks in the school. Okay, notebooks and textbooks are available in the school, so you can go and get it. Okay, shall we start the lesson now, children?
Okay, now we shall see the occurrence of metals and non-metals. Okay, so out of 92 naturally occurring elements, 70 are metals and about 22 are non-metals. So some elements show properties of both metals and non-metals, means some elements, in that elements only, some elements will be having both the properties of metals and non-metals. As I told you, metals will be having different properties and non-metals will be having different properties, but the elements which show the both the properties of metals and non-metals, those are called as metalloids. Those are called as metalloids. So only some metals like gold, silver, platinum, etc. are found in the free state. Okay, most metals are found in the combined state as oxides, sulfides, carbonates, silicates, etc. Okay. So some non-metals are found in the free state like helium, neon, argon, etc. And some are found in free and combined states like sulfur, phosphorus, etc. So these are the some occurrence of metals and non-metals, children. Okay, children. Shall we do one activity? Just listen to this. Take a small iron nail. Okay, a coal piece and a piece of a thick aluminium wire and a pencil lead. Okay, what you have to take? Small iron nail, coal piece, a piece of a thick aluminium wire and a pencil lead. Okay, beat the iron nail with a hammer. What happens? Obviously, the nail will bend. Okay, so try to hit hard. What happens? When you hit hard, it will bend little bit more. Now hit hard also the aluminium wire. Then repeat the same kind of treatment on the coal piece and pencil lead. What happens? Yes, the aluminium wire also will change its shape, isn't it? The shape of the iron nail and the aluminium wire changed on beating. Okay, if they are beaten harder, these could be changed into sheets. Okay, so and what about this pencil lead and coal? They will break into pieces, isn't it? They will break into pieces. So you might have be familiar with the silver foil also used for decorating sweets and all. So like that, when you hit more harder to the aluminium wire, it becomes like a that aluminium silver foil like. Okay, you must also have familiar with the aluminium foil used for the wrapping food and all. I think it you also will use that wrapping paper. It will be silver color. It is used to wrap the food, chapati, roti and all, to carry somewhere else. Okay, so the property of metals by which they can be beaten into thin sheets is called malleability. What is that? The property of metals by which they can be beaten into thin sheets is called malleability. So these are the some characteristics of property of metals. So materials like coal and pencil lead do not show this property because they will be broken into small pieces, isn't it? They will not change the shape, but they will be broken into pieces. So can you hold a hot metallic pan which is without a plastic or a wooden handle and not get hurt? Yes, because plastic handle, in which a wooden or plastic handle protects you from being hurt while handling hot things. Yes, that's why these cookwares are also covered with the plastic handling, isn't it? So on basis of these experiences, we can see that conduction of heat by wood and plastic. Okay, we can conclude the conduction of heat by wood and plastic. You must have seen an electrician using his screwdriver. I think children, you have seen that the screwdriver will be having the handle which is made up of a plastic. So it is a plastic. Why it is used? Because it is a bad conductor of a heat. Plastic is a bad conductor of heat. That's why it is used. Okay. Yes, children. Now we shall have one more activity. See that. Can you see in the picture there? You know how to make an electric circuit to test whether electricity can pass through the object or not. So you might have performed this activity with various objects. Now repeat this activity with the materials. Same as the dry cell and two copper wire and one bulb. Okay. And one nail also. Isn't it? So we have conducted this in previous classes also. So observe and group these materials into good conductor and poor conductor. So iron rod or a nail, is it a good conductor or bad conductor? Okay, now cell is a chemicalized, it is a dry cell which is filled with the chemical. So it is also whether a good conductor or bad conductor. And bulb and two copper wires. Okay, so we have to group this. So iron rod, nail and copper wire are good conductors, while rolled sulfur piece and a coal piece are poor conductors. Okay, so the property of metal by which it can be drawn into wires is called ductility. The property of metal by which it can be drawn into wire is called ductility. So have you ever noticed a difference in sound on dropping an iron sheet, plate, metal coin and a piece of a coal on the floor? Yes, children, there will be a different noises. Okay, when you drop the plate, the noise will be different. When you drop iron sheet, that noise will be different. When you drop a metal coin, that noise will be different, isn't it? For different substances, there will be a different type of sounds, isn't it, children? Okay. So the things made of metals produce a different sound, isn't it, when struck hard. Suppose you have two boxes similar in appearance, one made of wood and another made of metal. Can you tell which box is made of metal by striking both the boxes? Obviously, when we strike it, it makes a sound, isn't it? Metals produce ringing sounds. They are said to be sonorous. Okay. The materials other than metals are not sonorous. So after performing the above activities, we can say that some materials are hard, lustrous, malleable, ductile, sonorous and good conductor of heat and electricity. So the materials which generally possesses these properties are called metals. Okay, means which are hard, lustrous, malleable, ductile. So these properties possesses that these are metals. The examples of metals are some other examples like iron, copper, aluminium, calcium, magnesium, etc. Okay. In contrast, materials like coal, sulfur are soft and dull in appearance. They break down into a powdery mass on tapping with the hammer. Whereas these metals, for example, iron, copper, aluminium and all, they turn their shapes into different, isn't it? So they are not sonorous and are poor conductor of heat and electricity. So these materials are called non-metals. Which one? Coal and sulfur are called non-metals. Okay. So the examples of non-metals are sulfur, carbon, oxygen, phosphorus, etc. Okay. Metals like sodium and potassium are soft and can be cut with a knife. Mercury is the only metal which is found in liquid state at room temperature. Okay.